Hello everybody, SlimKirby here. Welcome back to more of the Mario Golf playthrough. Last time we did our project introduction, we also started the first half of the Toad Tournament, and in this video we're going to finish the second half of the Toad Tournament. We're currently tied in third place with 3 under par. We still have half the course to go, and I still feel like even though, you know, we are being outshot by people above us, I still have a feeling that they're going to be falling down at some point, so I think we, by all intents and purposes, have this tournament in the bag. We just need to keep playing the way that we have been playing these last few holes, and we should be good. But yeah, let's go ahead and move on to the second half as we go to the half turn, and hole number 10. This is a hole that, if you're a character that can hit the ball a decent distance, you can actually get on the green in one shot, but because we're plumb, we can't do that, so... Unfortunately, we have to go around this way. I think even if you get lucky with like the wind and use a power shot, like I still think it's too risky just because her shot arc doesn't go too high, and the trees are just they just reach so high up on this particular hole, so it's best not to try to push it too much. Meanwhile, this should be a really good shot. I think we should be able to get right next to the hole with no issue whatsoever. Kind of wish we would have got a little closer, but kind of the bounces. We didn't really get a good bounce right there, but that's okay. Because this should be a very makeable shot. Nice birdie. Hell yeah, 5 birdie badges too. We're 1/10 the way of getting our first birdie badge character. Who is actually a really good character, by the way, but we'll get to that later. Let's go ahead and keep going. Hole number 11. We're in heaven with hole number 11. Yes, I am a dork. Just thought you should know I'm a dork. I'm a big old dork. But that's what you guys love about me, right? Okay, so this should be alright. Also, if you press the button accidentally, don't press anything. Unlike other golf games, if the meter goes all the way back to the beginning without you pressing anything, you'll actually just stop right there and you won't lose your shot, basically. Something I do appreciate from the Mario Golf series that other golf games don't really do. Sometimes you just accidentally hit the button, and it's good to just be able to cancel it if you did. Okay, this shot should be alright. Oh, 40 feet? Never mind. And it's also a pretty slanty shot, too. So we don't want to hit to the second dot. A little under it. Maybe around the... Well... That should be good. That should be good. I just didn't hit it hard enough. That actually would have been a really nice shot if I hit it just, like, maybe a line further. Oh, well. Really? Oh my god. Well, it wouldn't be Mario Golf without that classic, very, very short miss, where you feel like you go on autopilot to make a very quick and easy shot, but then you just, like, whiff it and don't get it. It happens. It happens to the best of us. It happens to all the great Mario Golf players at some point. I almost said Mario Kart players, but... Maybe people who play Mario Golf also play Mario Kart, I guess. This is going to be kind of a scary shot. Hopefully the wind... Okay, yeah, the wind kind of saved me there. So one thing that I like to kind of look at whenever I'm taking a shot here is... You know, when you make your shot, you have to press the A button twice. One on the far left side and one on the far right side. On the right side... That gray line, if you hit it to the left of the gray line just a little bit, it'll actually curve more to the right, and if you hit it to the right side, it'll curve more to the left. You can kind of do that a little bit to kind of angle your shot if you think that, okay, maybe I need to go a little more in one direction. But, you know, it's obviously it's better just to make sure you have it perfect, I guess, as opposed to trying to depend on getting that crazy with your shot, I guess. But that is something I've definitely noticed while playing this game. Good skill to know. Okay, so this is shot number 3. Let's go one more club length. That should be okay. Come down, come down, come down! Ooh, that was a really good bounce. That was a really nice bounce.
Nice on.
Of all the bounces I could have gotten, that was like the bounce that I wanted.
Nice birdie.
Yes!
Yes! Oh, Plum. Okay, so we are in first place. And Toad, who's apparently playing with us, is right behind us with only 3 under, while we're 4 under. So Toad's doing a pretty good job. I don't think he'll pass us, though. Again, there's usually a threshold for every course in the tournaments that the computer players will never hit past a certain score. And I think we'll make that threshold easily. But we have another par 3, so once again, let's hope we get a hole-in-one. This could be kind of risky. Let me hit it a little more this way, just to assure that we don't hit the rough there.
Nice shot.
That was kind of a nice bounce. Just didn't bounce over the way I would have wanted it to. Like, it didn't bounce as far as I wanted it to. But we have a birdie shot, so I'll take that. Ah, damn. That's why I don't really like using the kind of the green-yellow medium putt, I guess is what they're called. Because it's not as accurate as the blue line. The blue line's way more accurate because it's less distance over a wider line, I guess. So you can kind of assign values a little more. Like this, we can aim right there, and that should be a good shot. Oh, God. Don't freak me out like that, game. Oh, well, we made it. We did good. We got it. That sound was me checking to see if I had power shots, which I definitely don't, because we wasted them, like, in the first half of the game. And I couldn't get another one to save my life, so, oh well. Come on, Plum, you can do it. This might be a little short. Actually, maybe not. Okay, we're on the green at least. We have a chance. Well, green edge, the fringe, whatever. Let's see. Even though it wasn't a chip, they still count that as a chip shot because you could have also chipped from the edge. But yeah, when you're on the green edge, honestly, I'd still say go ahead and putt. If you're on the green edge or if you're on the fairway just like right next to the green edge, I'd say putting is probably safer. But you can also chip if you feel more comfortable with that. You know, it's really up to the player, honestly, and that's what I like about this game. You have freedoms to play however you want. And freedoms to play with whatever character you want, too. I can't wait till we unlock some of my more favorite characters in this game. Huh. This is gonna... I might need to play this safe, and I'm probably not gonna get a birdie here as a result, but... You know, it's okay. It's better to, again, be safe than sorry. So I'm gonna hit over this way. Hopefully we land at least on... If we... Don't land on the green, we land on the fairway. Oh, we still made it on the green, just the edge again. But hey, we made the last putt on the edge. So, let's just say we do it again. I'm not expecting this to go in, though. Pretty damn close, though.
Nice approach.
Pretty damn close.
Nice par.
Might want to take me to Vegas with those odds, baby. Oh, gosh. Okay. Well, here's the last par 5 of this course. This can be a pretty difficult par 5, too, especially with, once again, the wind going back at me. Man, I've just gotten really bad wind on this tournament. I don't know. It's always seemed to come back at me. This is a fun par 5 to attack, though, if you have, like, a really far... hitting character. Because you can kind of hit it past these trees to the very top of the hill, hit it past this canyon and get it on the green, but because we're Plum, we have to kind of hit it into the canyon and hit our way out. And it's better to do that when you're kind of in the middle here, so let's just aim it here. We shouldn't hit any of the trees, so... Nice, nice, nice. We did it. Ooh. It's kind of going into the canyon there, like into the side, which... We may not want that, but unfortunately I don't exactly have a... power shot or anything to get us out of that. Also, there's wind, too, so I'm also trying to compensate for that as well. This might look crazy, but what I'm going to do here is I'm going to try to see if I can hit the ball at the bottom so I can maybe get a little bit of loft out of it. Let me try this. That should work. Like, even if I do this shot normally, it still might not actually hit the actual, like, grass as it looks like it's going to. It's just, it's a very basic line, but still. Again, we are hitting it uphill to a pretty big degree, so I'm trying to just do this. And basically, if we want to hit this shot the way it's shown now, when we're doing the shot meter, we have to be holding down on the control stick is basically what we need to be doing, so... Okay, that's good. That's a pretty nice shot, too. Honestly, I probably could have gotten that other shot and gotten even closer, but, not a big deal. Curving to the left a little bit. Got it. So from the look of it, we'll be getting birdies on, like, half the holes, which is not too bad. And again, if I come back here later with another character, a character that hits harder, I'll have, like, a lot more shots for a birdie in some holes. Because there were some holes where Plum couldn't quite make it with her distance. So once again, it's raining. I'm going to hope that this is going to be enough. I want to say wind is not too powerful when it's raining either. Oh, shoot. Ah, damn it. The wind really, or not really the wind, but the rain really got to it there. Okay, well that's kind of unfortunate. We're in the sand. With sand, I find that you want to hit it a little harder than what you would normally do it, but not too much. Like, basically the first dot is the distance that we are from the hole, so maybe like just a little under that, or a little above that. Ooh, that was not great. At least we have a par putt at the very least. This is a weird case where it looks like it's going to the right here. But it looks like it's going the other way here. So maybe I just leave it alone where it's at, if anything. Ah! Dang it, that was actually really close. I would have probably gone in if it was more online. Oh well. We should still win the tournament, no problem. I think Toad's at like... Oh, Toad's at back at even. So yeah, we have a 5-shot advantage going into the last hole, so we should be fine. But yeah, considering that we've gotten like a couple of bogeys, like I'm not disappointed with my score here. Like, 5 under par is a good score. Especially for a character that just can't really, like, attack greens as aggressively as other characters because of her distance. So I'm not at all disappointed with my performance on this one. Also, this is probably one of the hardest holes of the course, hole 18. It's just a bit long, and it's a very awkward green, too. And it's hard to really attack it because there's like such a dip on like different sides of the green, too, so it's just kind of a hard hole to attack, really. Okay, so not exactly halfway, like, this should do it. Oh yeah, and I'll take that for sure. Okay, well, that is the first tournament of Mario Golf.
Nice par.
Did I perform to the best of my ability? Probably not, but we still got a first place. And that's all that really matters, so... You know, GG everybody. It looks like Toad didn't even get a second place. Ken from Street Fighter did. And Kobe Bryant comes in fourth place. Followed by Bob-omb. See, how did the other people do? Who came in last place? Peppy Hare didn't do a good job. Obviously does not feel in his element. He prefers space golf, I guess. And yeah, just, there's a fox and there's also a McLeod. So maybe Fox is, like, actually Fox McLeod and McLeod is, like, James McLeod, maybe? I don't know. Sheik didn't do too bad. Fly Guy actually fell down quite a bit. Fly Guy was at the top of the leaderboard at one point. He had a very bad end of the round, I guess. Okay, well, that's about it. We got 8 of the birdie badges. Wish I would have got a little more, but it is what it is. Let's do this.
Great round, go.
Thank you, announcer guy. We get 54 experience points. It's hard to explain this. Experience points don't actually do anything for your character in this game. It's just kind of a... Just kind of a special value that they made to just, I don't know, just show how well you did, I guess. But it's actually interesting. Like, I think they actually come into play when you're, like, doing the transfer characters. Because maybe they get experience when you play with them in this game, and that's what that's taken into consideration. I think. I really don't know. I've never really understood why they have an experience point value there. But either way... We got the gold trophy, gave us 50 points, made us unlock our next course, and we have 250 to the next course. And the experience points, they do attribute to the course points as well. So that does kind of help us get a little closer to unlocking the next course, I guess. I guess that is what they're used for. Like, once you unlock all the courses, it really doesn't matter anymore, which is, again, the weird thing. But yeah, that's going to do it for the first round of Mario Golf. I think what I'm actually going to do is, because this is the start of a new project, I think I'm just going to actually upload both of these videos on the same day, because it's kind of, you know, the project opening. With all the introduction stuff and all the stuff I've already explained, I probably won't need to go over that stuff again. So because of that, I imagine the like explanations for stuff might take a lot less time. And we should be able to get through videos a lot quicker. So I'll go ahead and do that instead of actually, like, just doing, like, you know, half a course per video. But yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed. I'll see you guys next time when we actually, we're going to actually see if we can unlock a new character. We are going to go back to Toad Highlands, but, you know, we are going to try to unlock a new character and also just kind of show a different mode of play in addition to that. So... that's what we're doing next time. Hope you guys enjoyed, and I'll see you guys next time for that. Later, folks.